Paint a picture of what you're seeing right now as you look at people preparing to make their plans for the fourth quarter and early next year.
Sure. Yeah, look, the quarter is the best way for me to explain the quarter to you is to talk about business demand. It really is really what drove it. We started out really strong. Business demand, you know, we like to look at in terms of revenues versus 2019 business revenues. That number was like 25% back in March. It had grown to over 50, slightly over 50% in June. In July, it was 64%. Business travel was coming back. We were profitable in the month of July. And then, of course, the Delta variant hits. And we saw August and September fall. Business demand in September was actually back below 50% again. So the result of all that is a profitable July, not profitable August, September. And we had a loss. It's the smallest loss we've had since the pandemic, so that's good. But look, I look at all that, and some people look at that and are discouraged because we were doing well and now it's fallen
right
back. But I think it's encouraging. What it says is business travel wants to come back. We saw it in July. 64% of 2019 demand versus being 29% or 25% in March is huge growth.
So with that as your expectation, as we see cases drop, more corporate travel return, when do you expect to get back to profitability? Is it Q1, Q2? When will you say, I think this is when we're there?
Yeah, I got to caveat that with whenever business travel comes back again.
And so it has to be fully back?
Well, not fully back. Again, we were profitable in July with business travel 64% of 2019.
Okay.
Oil prices have gone up. I got to be careful about making specific financial forecasts, of course. But what I know is once business travel comes back, which it will, you'll see all of us return to profitability. We saw it in June. We were profitable in June as well. We were profitable in June and July. We weren't in August and September as the variant had its impact. But as all that goes away, as we get past this pandemic, I'm highly confident. American and all airlines, you're going to see return to profitability.
November 8th is when Europeans who are fully vaccinated can start flying here into the U.S. We've heard from other CEOs in the airline industry who have said people are chomping at the bit to do those trips over to Europe. What are you seeing?
It's the same. And Europeans chomping at the bit to come to the United
You're
States.
You're seeing that on the other
absolutely.
Side.
Absolutely. Yeah. They were precluded from coming here.
Right.
We saw enormous pickup, double-digit percentages in all areas on the day that this was announced. So there absolutely is pent-up demand for international travel. I suspect by next summer, you're going to see full flights back to Europe again, and as many flights as we were flying, or close to as many flights as we were flying before. There's enormous international demand, pent-up demand.
The other deadline that you're going to be facing here within the next couple of months is, as a federal contractor, having full vaccination for your company, with the caveat being there may be some religious or medical exceptions for some of your employees. Where are you at right now? What percentage of your employees are vaccinated?
Yeah, well, we just completed at the end of September a voluntary program for people. We got the vast majority of our people already done. We do indeed now have a mandate for November 24th where everyone needs to be vaccinated, so we're going to get that done. By November 24th, we're either going to have everyone vaccinated or some small subset of religious or medical exemptions. It's a mandate. We're going to be compliant with the mandate. We're going to be able to do so and have all of our people still continue to work and be ready to fly for the holidays.
What happens if you get to the 24th and you have, 2, 3, 4% of your employees who are not vaccinated, who do not have an exception? How much would that impact you? Or do you look at this and say, look, the 24th is the deadline, but we're going to work with the federal government?
Yeah, look, first off, I don't think that's possibly going to happen. What I know is, again, we have the vast majority already vaccinated. We're seeing, since we put the mandate in place, seeing that number increase every day. What I fully suspect is we'll get to the 24th and have, not very many people still left unvaccinated. Those that are almost certainly will be on some sort of religious or medical exemption. And those that aren't, we'll continue to work with. We don't want to see anybody leaving America. No, I don't think anyone's going to leave America because of this. We're going to have people working to, we're going to have our team fully vaccinated or else with exemptions, or with exemptions, and we're going to be fine.
Shepard Smith here. Thanks for watching CNBC on YouTube.